Game on. Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Ardent, rule the water.
Now that's why they call me the extreme.
Strike King Lure Company, gearing up champions for over 40 years. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
Told ya. Oh, good one too. Do this thing. This week, I'm gonna show you a little bait that I use for smallmouth bass on heavily fished cottage lakes.
We'll be right back.
Hey, welcome back to another Extreme Angler TV. You know what? I get a lot of emails from people asking about, you know, they love watching the show, catching walleyes, smallmouth, largemouth, pike, big crappie, you name it. But a big question I get is, what are you using? You know, and I'm not going to turn this into a big advertorial. I think there's enough shows that just go on about product all the time. You want to see fishing, but you want to know what I'm using. Okay, you know what? St. Croix's got this brand new rods out called Eyecon. And today I'm going to go out and chase some walleyes, okay? Early summer, a nice sunny day, the weed's up high, the water's in the low 60, 63, 64 degrees, and I'm gonna just match the right baits, right line, rods, colors, different things that I feel are gonna make a big difference in catching those walleyes. So you know what? Today, sit back, enjoy the show, but take something from it. How I do it, where I'm throwing the bait, and what I'm using. Put all those things together like a puzzle, and you're gonna catch them too. You know what? The best cakes have the best ingredients. You put them all together, you got a great cake. So today, sit back, because you're gonna have your cake and eat it too on Extreme Angler TV. All right, Eyecon, you're gonna get a workout today, boys. Let's go and do it. I wanna be right on that edge where the weed drops off to that deeper main lake basin. I'm not talking really far out, just talking from 8 to maybe 10, 8 to 11 or 12. Real simple stuff, but the kind of stuff that brings those walleyes where they're holding those edges. The sun's gonna get up high today. That just might change a little bit more I'm actually gonna fish. But you find these weeds in these lakes, it's almost a guarantee there's gonna be walleyes present somewhere. But the trick is to find exactly where the bigger ones are and the aggressive ones are. Move around to different spots, different locations, but the right tackle. Put it all those pieces together, it's like a puzzle, and you're gonna catch them too. It's so important to pay attention when you're casting out the underhand shots. I'm watching my sonar, how deep it is. I say it all the time, you're making long bomb casts, you cannot see those subtle edges in the weeds and put your bait exactly where you want it to be, where you think those walleyes are. It's imperative to pay attention. Catch the fish in front of you, then move. It's all about paying attention and focus and using the right equipment. Little 6-3 rods, and I'm fishing in fairly open water, so this 8-pound test is more than fine enough. And pull those fish out of that sparse weed. But it's sensitive, and it matches all my equipment. 6-3 medium action rod. Sure can't beat the morning. Beautiful. Gorgeous day. Sun rising. Out chasing walleyes. And look at that. Holy cow, eh? Look at this. You see what I mean about getting on the spot? Making it happen? Look at this. A real nice pick. That's how I like to start my day, with the right tackle. Look. And that's what we do on Extreme Angler. When you use the right stuff, it all comes together like magic, man. I tell you, phenomenal. Look how we ate that, hey? Very traditional walleye. Inhale, and get those pliers. It's all about being prepared, the right tackle, so you can catch, photograph, and release. And that's how it is when using the right gear for walleyes in early summer. I'm gonna put these Eyecon rods to the test today, trust me. Let's see, ready you? Go on, get down there. Again, it's all about working the right stuff, using the right little nets, the basket nets by Lucky Strike. They're a basket style, the fish don't wrap up and get all twisted up, easy for catch and release. The right size baits, the right size, the right colors, matching it to the line and rod and reel. We're gonna do all that today so you can go out in summer and catch them too. Let's get a real big one. So imperative to have sonar, the right gear. In this case, it's only 8 feet of water, so I got a real light little jig head. Again, matching it. A little grub, chartreuse, a little bit of silver and blue, contrasting tones. Fish can see it in short casts, right to my target areas where I feel those walleye should be sitting. 9 times out of 10, they're gonna eat it. But I got the wind blowing in here, so I like sitting downwind and fish up a little ways. So if I find a spot on the spot, I can stay off it, make short pitches to it, and hopefully catch those fish. And don't keep drifting over it. Just stay back from it. As I catch a fish or something happens, get bit off by a muskie or something, you can just drift down, go back up to the spot. And this outside weed line, 9.5 feet with weed. Nice sparse weed. See if there's any big picks hanging around. Nice cabbage. Any big old gals just cruising on those edges? Let's see. Yeah. Oh, nice picky too, look at that, hey? See that? Get on the right spot. Look it. That's a nice little pickerelli. I think I can almost swing her in here. Come here, you. There you go. Look where he got it. You just know it, eh? When you feel that tick, look at that, right through the schnoz. Just a nice, another eater. What do you think, huh? Oh, no way. Look at them sharp little things, eh? Look at that, little vampires, little teeth at the bottom. Wicked little things. They destroy minnows. Ready? Go on. So you know what? When I'm using the right line and the right rod and reel, in this case, the 6.3 medium action, there's a medium light as well, the Eyecon with the Yarden 2500 or the 2000 reel, light line, you know, copolymer, 8 pound, that's all you need. I can pull these fish out of weed and rock and stuff, but you gotta keep your line fresh. Keep it fresh, it'll keep you happy because you won't break off fish. You know, sometimes I put on that, the Real Care and just spray in that, you know, Real Magic by Blake Moore. It keeps the line real subtle and stuff and smooth, but the drag, loosen it off when the fish is pulling, tighten it up, get those solid hook sets and the rod. The rod, reel, line, right bait, the right spot, and you're gonna catch them. Let's go get some more. See? Cabbage mixed with this stuff. And when you got that, look at it, beautiful. Real nice and healthy, green stuff. You know those walleyes are hanging around that. You got that with the cabbage and this with the right line, right rods and reels, you are gonna make it happen. When I'm fishing walleyes, I always make sure I got scent on. It is so, so important. A few little sprays will do ya. keep it handy, keep it fresh. You know, little salty baits, they got impregnated with salt and scent and all that kind of stuff, but scent is key for catching those walleyes when they're not super aggressive, like chasing hair jigs and stuff. I won't really put it on hair jigs because that's a reaction strike or jerk bait, but grubs and soft plastics, definitely. I do not take my eyes off that line. When that line's in the water, I wanna make sure. And if something different on there, like a little bit of weed, these sensitive little Eyecon rods, they'll feel it. Pick it up, put it back out in the spot, bring your line over, let it rest, fall straight down, watch your sonar, and let the walleyes do all the rest. Just grab that little bait. Come on, fish. There's gotta be more fish here. Sitting on the outside weed line. Where are you, big boy? Huh? Picking up them bucks, 2-pounders, creel limits, slot limits, keeps the population healthy. Respect that. Check in all the lakes you fish. See what you can catch and keep and eat. You know, sometimes that 13.5-inch, 14-inch to 21 to 23, you're in the slot. Let those fish go. Have fun catching them. Keep some of the smaller ones to eat. They're a lot more sweeter anyway. Respect the resource. It'll be here for future generations to enjoy. Got waypoints right here. Oh yeah, there's some streaks here. Get ready. Get ready, my boy. My line is gonna stretch. Dunk. Told ya. Oh, good one too. Look at this thing. Look at that, nice little pickerelli, eh? Look at him in the water, shaking his head. Oh yeah, just shaking all around. Dancing fool. Oh, look at that. See what happens when you're on him good? I got a feeling this guy got it under the chin. He did too. So you know what that tells you? That they're looking for it. They want to eat it. They're aggressive. He's probably chasing it with another one. Look. So you just take that, pull that out. You gotta let him go right away. But what happens is that little grub, lifting and falling, lifting and falling. It sits on the bottom like that. Walleye comes over, he's looking for it, or he's just taking a peek at it. And I'm just lifting slow, bang, got him under the chin. So sometimes when you're ripping, a lot of times, pay attention right under the boat. Because you lift up, you can catch those walleyes right below the boat. Don't have to always cast really far. In walleye fishing, you want to work the areas you see right close to you. You know, find the little intersections inside the weed line, outside weed line, edge of a rock. Walleyes love to hold to that kind of stuff. If it's really choppy and windy and stuff, they can be wandering everywhere chasing bait, you know. But when it's subtle like this, the walleyes are a little bit tighter to the cover, make sure your bait is right where it should be and you'll catch them. Let's get some more. You know what, one good thing about fishing is you have options. Now when I'm fishing every little shallow stuff, I got that 1/8-ounce jig head. I really believe in fishing slower for those walleyes. Give them an opportunity to see that bait fall in front of their nose and just eat it. But like anything in life, options, you gotta have them, especially for fishing. I put down this Eyecon. It's a 6'3", medium action. And when I'm fishing a little bit deeper, like I'm gonna find some of those bigger walleyes, I'll go to my old reliable Legend Extreme, but with a 1/4-ounce jig head, different color grub, you know, little offset, a little bit of pumpkin with chartreuse. Just give them something different to see. I'm fishing an area that I see fish on the sonar. I know they're here. I got two here, but maybe they're just maybe sitting a little bit closer to the edges, the deeper slopes. So what I want to do is get that bait and that little grub closer to where those fish are sitting, deeper water, quicker. I don't have to fish that real high water column with a lighter jig head, wasting all that time. Now, it's not really a waste of time, but I wanted to get my bait in front of those fish quicker so they can see it. Let's see what happens. Come on, fish. Come on. Like I said, a little bit deeper, bigger jig head. In this case, it's only 1/4-ounce. But I start getting bit on the way down. Let's say 6-7 feet down, 8 feet down, over 10 to 12 feet of water. I'll go to the lighter jig head again, even in the deeper stuff, because that'll show me that they're sitting higher up in the weeds. I want them to take advantage of that, not miss it and go down the weed. Then they gotta go and look for it. then sometimes you get underneath the chin. Most times you put it in the right spots, and the right spots are right here like this, in the cabbage. Cabbage, milfoil mix, if it's green, and there's walleyes present, there's a good chance you're gonna catch them. The edge of the weeds. Come on, fish. There's my grub. Eat it up. Oh, missed one there, wow. But then again, there's perch here. Something ding that, there he is. Oh yeah, good fish. Oh, look at this. Oh wow, hey, I just said, missed a good bite. It's a big walleye. Oh, look at them fight, hey folks. I just said, oh yeah, look at that. Look at them scrap, eh? Who says walleye don't fight, man? Look how nice they scrap. Just a real nice little fish. Look at him. See what I mean? Tell me that's not fun. Oh, look at that. The jig just popped out. Look at that, eh? But see what I mean with the lucky strike net? It's a basket net. The fish doesn't wrap up inside. He just stays subtle. Look at that. He ain't going anywhere. It's easy on the fish. Easy for catch and release, like we're gonna do here with this one. You ready? You gonna flare all your gills and stuff? Give me some scars. Well, easy now. I'm gonna put him back. Look at him, just a subtle fish. I'm just holding him like that, not squeezing him. Look at that, beautiful, great scrapper. But again, a little bit deeper, change the jig to a quarter ounce. You ready to go back? Look how beautiful they are, little white tips. Down he goes. Options, you gotta have options fishing walleyes. Rod choices around 6'3", 6'6", I might go to 7 foot, but that medium action, medium light, 8 pound. I'll go down to 6 pound test fluorocarbon if I have to. The fish are real finicky and stuff, but water's got a little bit of color to it. It's perfect green. But for me, matching the right tackle, you catch the walleyes, you can do it too. I'm gonna regroup, and hopefully one of those hook sets or that real big one. Like you saw in that fish, I missed the first little bite. It was like, doo-doo. I dropped it down again. What happened? Lift up, he was already there. Good stuff. It's gonna be zoo nuts in a second. Watch this. Ding dong, boom bang. Oh, I love it when it happens, man. Cause I'm putting this little bait in the danger zones, in this stuff. Oh, green milfoil. You know what, putting it right in there. Even if they're not aggressive, it doesn't matter. You're putting it right on their kitchen plate. And when they see it, you put something on my kitchen plate, guess what? Gone. Same with Mr. Walleye. He sees it, even though he's not hungry, he'll eat it. You know, it's all relative to really what you want to use, what your disposable income is, what you want to spend on your fishing tackle. But a company like St. Croix comes out every year with innovation. Mojo Bass, Mojo Muskie, and now the Eyecon, specially made for the walleye fishermen like you and me. Inexpensive, the quality, craftsmanship is there. It's something that just, you know what, they're leaders in the industry on innovation and craftsmanship. That's why I use St. Croix. Here's the edge. Should get bit right here. Got bit right there. See, and a nice fish too. Just a fat little pickerel. I'm shaking his head. He was right below the boat, eh? Right below the boat, sitting in the same locations, different spot, but same kind of stuff, right in the weed. Look at him, just a gorgeous, gorgeous, beautiful little pickerel, eh? Look at him, flaring his gills, those big eyes, they see everything, man. Trust me, they see it all. Are you ready to go? Look at him flaring his gills. But I want a big one to end the show. Let's try to get one. Come on, fish. The chop is up. The water's warm. The sun's up. I'm getting hungry. I want to catch one so we can go. Well, see what I mean? Using the right tackle in the right spots, having a variety of different size jig heads, different size line hooks, bait sizes, it's all relevant to catching more and bigger walleyes on different bodies of water whether it be Georgian Bay, Perry Sound, or the Kawarthas, it doesn't matter. Alter your approach, use different baits, different colors, but stick with the stuff that works. St. Croix Rods, the new Eyecon, you proved it today. You saw it works, man, it's great. Very affordable combination, the Ardent 2500S series, 8th ounce jig heads. And then the good old Legend Extremes. You know I gotta have the Ardent S2500s. This one had a 1/4 inch ball head. Same 3 inch little body grub, 8 pound test. I stuck with those combinations. They did it. So next time you're out, stick with the things that work. Quality rods and reels, good line, alter your baits, alter your depth, and you can catch them too. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV. Get hooked on big, fat walleye. Oh, Lordy. Somebody bundle and call the cops. Snag Proof, the world's finest weedless lures. Fishoflage, for love of the sport. Daiichi, bleeding red hooks. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.